All right, so I guess today I really, you know, back to the politics, the structure of this the world that we're in right now. It's really set up for, you have to look at the past 50 years. Each business that has been, you know, put into place the last 50 years, you know, building, construction, blah, blah, blah. It's set up for that. It's not set up for now. The current state of economics in your pocketbook, it's set up for the past 50 years. Okay, so those businesses, those commercial entities, that's the methodology. That's the only methodology that that's utilized. Do you know what I'm saying? That's the only one that. So you're out on a whim. You're like, well, I'll just go, you know, over here, and I'll just do that, you know, and be Miss Permaculture, or whatever. You're out on a whim. You're just out on a whim. You're not supported. You have to look at this group that hauls themselves off to work. Okay, we're talking about sustainable living, off-grid living. We're talking about people that support themselves and do not require outside means of income. They don't even require money aside from the property tax. Okay, so when we're living this way, there's a lot of people that are like against it. They're against you. I've seen a lot of these people that go, they build their cute little cob houses, and they get burned down. I'm like, well, what's the deal with that? That was really cool. Somebody would build something like that and they burn it down. What's wrong with human beings? That they cannot take something that is really wonderful and good and true for the planet, and they prefer to just stick with that old diehard. That's the way we did it. And so you have to do it also. You know what I mean? They have that mentality. So unfortunately, when I look at these new ways of constructing, it really has to be like you've got the tire dome, the earth ships up there in Taos, New Mexico. It really has to be done with such a bombasta, such an announcement that there's a safety there, that nobody is gonna just attack you being the single person trying to be your own little architect on the side. You know, nobody is going to attack you for making your sustainable living. So you have their aggressions. They went and they paid for their house to be built their particular way, you know. That you're looking at their consumer build. You know, they're walking down the street, they're in their car with their consumer build in their brains. You know, they've have that consumer mentality. And they're resellers of it. And they're a reseller so much that they could hurt you. So when I look at how we're going to actually make more and more of these sustainable buildings and blah 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 blah, you can't even put or like a cob house right here in the middle of San Francisco. You know, you're going to have a lot of aggression. An aggression from people that have built their house the normal way. You understand? They built everything the normal way. You're like, well, what about my property values? Okay, so you can have that. Even though it could be worth $1 million at the end, it's still going to be, what about my property values? You're going to have aggressive neighbors just based upon that. So I'm exhausted by it. I'm exhausted by this consumer group. But the consumer group is huge. It's a massive group that's been fed. It's a massive group that does not want to be debt-free. It's a massive group They live with their I'll call it their workhorse mentality, that they have been fed that is the method. They work. They capture their Social Security, and they die. That is where they live. And along the way, they go to the regular home buying a building supply store. And they maybe buy a house, and it's a regular normal house. And they pay their regular property tax, and they vote. Oh my God. Chances are, sustainable human being, you don't even vote. You know, you're just some kind of derelict of society. You know, this is what we're dealing with. That's their consumer brain. Because they cannot walk in. They're looking at you with this consumer brain. Okay. Now, because when you walk into, let's say, I can't even say the names of the stores, but yeah, some of those home, because I'm in America now, you can't really say anything name of the store. But yeah, let's say you go into one of those big home building stores. Okay, so you go into one of those. And let's say, you know, you are not the pockets out. You know, you're not going to be the pockets to purchase that standard building. You know, the standard building, the one that looks like theirs even. You're not the pockets out. You're not paying it out on the table. You know, you're not welcome. So we have a rift here. We have the permaculture group that just is not welcome, not even in that store. because yeah, you're just looking for what, the cheapest things you can buy, and then not even that. You know, maybe just ideas. You go in there for ideas, for building, and on equipments. So yeah, you're really, you're like a treason to the economic system. You're a treason to them, even as taxpayers, because they're like, well, do I even have to pay for you? You know, do I have to pay for you, for your food line? Because they presume that you are some decadent thing they have to pay for, that the government, you're their government cheese line. You know what I'm saying? That's what they're in the presumption of. So anyway. So yeah, so you have a lot of negative group against you. So you look at the balance of, gosh, this has been going on for how many years? 30 years, 40 years, 50 years. How many years have we been making these earth constructions? Thousands. But in this consumer-taught 100-year time, the consumer-taught, my gosh, they were good at advertising. Ever since the tiny bubbles, you know, the tiny bubbles coming out of your washing machine, they were very, very good at advertising. They're good at advertising to you. So you have the advertised consumer brains, you know, and those are often, many times often, your neighbors. So yeah, so permaculture is really hit hard by this situation. We can't really have great success. And then I'm like, well, I figured the Bay Area we would, but we've had so much influx from other people, from other areas of the world, that I don't see permaculture here as successful. It really has to be out there in these off-grid places. But unfortunately, in the off-grid places, you live with that, oh my gosh, I'm just alone. I'm just alone by myself, and I'm surrounded by either mobile homes, and I'm like, well, maybe the mobile home people aren't so happy either, you know, because they're still living their 9-to-5 to Social Security, that mantra. Many of them are not living off-grid. Many of them are not living sustainable or permaculture, you know, with real keeping their food growing all year round, or saving it, you know, saving it for winter storage all year round. So not all year round, but all through winter. So you're not having that. You're not having that. Okay. So, oh, it's just infuriating. It's infuriating when I look at, we're talking about the wall, we're talking about building a wall. There's a wall here in the United States, a wall here in the United States, just based upon the permaculture group. Oh, unless you're the one of those. What, you're the permaculture that just died? You have the $200,000 and you go and you have the out there, you just have the house already done, and then you just start being sustainable. Well, I'm not talking about you. Of course you're loved and adored. I'm not talking about you. So, we're talking about the permaculture people that have no money. And so they have a stigma association, and it really is. It's just like the Roman Colosseum of stones being thrown. So I don't want really women going out there into the deserts and building their little cob houses and finding their silly land with not very many trees. I don't want them there alone. I know what it's like there. They're aggressive human beings. They have aggressive children. I had neighbors that would turn their music on so loud, so very, very loud, just to drive us out of there. They didn't want us there. When you have people like that, and they use their children, they train their children to be evil. Don't ever think that it's going to be the answer. So I'm really looking at, there's not a safety unless you're with a larger group. So we were talking about the Rancho Mirages and their gated communities. Essentially, we have to be a gated community of women. I'll say women. Maybe one day there could be, the one with men also, but the point is there's just no security, there's no safety when you're there on your own on the land doing these permaculture, these cob building constructions. And I don't want to be tell somebody to stop and ruin their life, but I don't want you to have to go there and walk the property around with a gun and change your whole personality. Because I've met those women also that walk around their property with a gun, and they're insane. You want to talk about what's insane? That's not a way to live. You know, the gun is for the man that may approach, the gun is for the cougar. No. It's just not a good way to go. So, I'm just trying to... When you think about your group, where is your group? You know, where is your group? So anyway, so yeah, so that's all. I was just elaborating a little bit more on that, like women that are single. I'll call them single, and maybe they're still married. Who knows? But it doesn't matter. They need a place to live. Separate. And do something healthy for themselves, away from their particular environment. So yeah, I don't know, but yeah, the whole deal about going to those places, you know, like New Mexico or Utah or whatever, doing all these builds out there in the middle of the desert, you have to have some kind of a secure situation. Okay. Anyway, yeah, you don't want to get desert blasted by teenagers, because you know, and then you can call the police when you're out there, and they'll come and they'll show up, but it'll be a little too late, you know. They'll show up when you're way out there rural, but it's just too late, you know, and it just becomes a chat. You know, it's like, hey, nice to talk to you, but yeah, they already did what they were going to do, and were annoying, and you know, and you don't want to keep, every single time they have their little annoying habit, you know, keep bothering the sheriff or whoever. And so what happens is they drive you out. They drive you away from your little rural life. And they literally force you to sell. That's what happened to me. That's what happened to me in New Mexico. So yeah, this is a reminder. you don't want that situation going on. Some really awful people.